Today I'm going to be teaching you all how to apply for Moderator and some quick tips I would recommend to make your application stronger. So, like you see here, I'm a mod on this server. Senior, been so since January 2018. Had quite a lot of experiences here in terms of hacker catching and punishing rule breakers. It's pretty fun if you want to take a look at my Catching Hackers series that's up on my channel. And if you're interested in being a mod, keep in mind you do not get free VIP and you are not able to give yourself creative or any items. It's purely a role for responsibilities and if you want to help this community make it better. So don't apply if you're just looking for handouts. So yeah, let's hop right into it. Here's the application link, lvsg.net/volunteer. I'm going to paste this into a browser, and then I'm going to walk you guys through the application and the specifics. Alright, so welcome to Google, and we're going to go to lvsg.net/volunteer. Enter, wait for it to load in. So you're greeted by this website right here. So there's a couple other volunteer positions you can apply for, like translator, beta tester, Discord moderator, marketplace artist. There's also some other staff positions if you look around the website, such as developer. In-game moderator, so this is the one we're looking for. Click that. Loads in. See, hello all, this is where you may apply for a position on our team as a moderator. When you apply, please be descriptive and truthful in what you write, as this will count towards our decisions when choosing new mods. When you apply, if we like what we see, we'll get back to you. So, something about truthful. You cannot have other people write your application for you, okay? You can ask for help in terms of like grammar and like having other people review it, see if it's good. But if someone else writes your application for you and we find out, you'll be removed from the team. That's not an accurate representation of who you are if you don't write your own application. So it's not really we're accepting you at that point. It's like we're accepting the person that wrote that application. So here we have a little rubric. You can see what you need to do. They have suggestions for good grammar, past experience, XML application, and it recommends you submit a resume. So they want you to double check as well, make sure you answer all the questions. This is just some really basic stuff if you want to read through this. I don't want to go too in-depth on this. I have my own explanation on what I think a good application should comprise of. And talking about a mandatory agreement that must be signed upon acceptance, that's an NDA. Basically, you can't leak anything from the mod team outside, so I wouldn't be able to post like screenshots of the staff chat because that's violating my NDA. Since I'm a minor, my parents had to approve the form. So same for you if you're applying under the age of 18. And do not email us inquiring about your application or ask another staff member about status. So this is one thing a lot of players tend to do. I get messages like, hey, can you check my application? Hey, can you ask a staff member to check my application? Can you accept my application? It's not something that I have a say into. Like, I'm a moderator, but I'm not the one reviewing applications. That's something the lead moderators or staff members do. And they will obviously review them by time of submission, so they'll review the most recent ones, the ones submitted further back first. So don't constantly spam mods or staff asking to review your application, as it's annoying and it won't speed up the process at all. And allow up to a month for review. Generally, if you are accepted, it does not take a month, but it can take like a week or more. It's just generally we don't want users applying multiple times a month. So it says we recommend not applying again until 2 to 3 months past your last submission. This is generally because if we don't see you as a person fit to be in the position, it's not likely that in a month you'll somehow change your entire personality and be able to get in. So generally we recommend waiting this time limit so you can mature a bit and maybe improve on your grammar or whatever that caused you not to get accepted last time. So the form, so the application itself, enter your name and then email, personal email, that is what the acceptance will go to. Your Xbox username is basically your in-game username. It's just whatever Just, like, don't get confused. If you don't own an Xbox, that does not matter. Every player that plays on servers has an Xbox Live username. And Discord username. You also need to include the tag. This is a way we can another way we can contact you, and also on the server if we need to give you a rank. And time zone. A lot of people don't know what a time zone is. So it says you can Google my time zone. For example, I'm EST, Eastern Standard Time. Currently, it's 2:26 p.m. So someone in CST, it would be 1:26 p.m. You get the idea. Just search up time zone if you're confused. But make sure you enter this in so we know. And then, have you ever moderated or volunteered for a server network that is currently partnered with Microsoft? So that would be Hive, Cubecraft, Lifeboat, Mineplex, Mineville. Probably missing one. But you get the idea. Currently partnered with Microsoft, meaning in the servers tab where you don't have to enter an IP address. It's just shown at the top. Enter your age. So the minimum age, I confirmed with the admin about this yesterday. The minimum age is 14. But just because you're above 14 doesn't guarantee you'll be accepted. You have to be somewhat mature. Like, there are cases I've seen where, like, someone like 15, 14 is more mature than a full grown adult. They just don't cause the same drama. We put this age requirement in place to make sure our volunteers are reliable. Just some people at a younger age group wouldn't be able to handle situations with the same skill as older individuals. So, how long do you spend in-game on Lifeboat? I believe this is referring to every day. And you just want to select a choice that applies to you. Have you ever been punished in-game or on Lifeboat platforms? I don't recommend lying about this, because we can check your ban history. And if you have a ban on your account, and you said no, you're obviously lying, and we won't accept you. So resume attachment, you can attach a PDF. The thing is, there's a maximum character on this descriptive box that you can type, and if you hit this, I would just recommend making your application on a resume, like describing you, and then add on a little extra paragraph here. So the bulk of my application was actually on my resume as opposed to in this box. So that's just the general layout, but if you're not going to hit 5,000 characters, don't worry about it. So on to like suggestions for your application. I would, one thing you want to do is first brief introduction, your name, who you are, definitely some experience, like have you moderated in the past? If you haven't, don't worry. I hadn't had any moderation experience before I applied on Lifeboat, so just maybe talk about some leadership experiences you've had, even if it's in real life, like, oh, I was the leader of this Boy Scout troop or something. That's something that would be pretty decent to write. So we're looking for people that would be a role model for the Minecraft community. So if you've had any leadership experience, feel free to jot that down. And definitely, experience, like how long you've been on the played on the network. Like, if you've had any experience in the Lifeboat Discord server, that might be something worth noting. Or you're friends with, like, mods or staff to the point where, like, you know what's going on inside the team and why you want to help. Definitely talk about, like, your personality traits that might make you a reliable mod. Like, say you're, like, you're very loyal to the server and you wouldn't, like, leak any information. Or you're very calm and patient. Those are some traits that you could, like, write down and maybe give examples of that. You've had that would be beneficial to moderation program. These don't necessarily have to be in-game. They can be in real life. Like I said earlier, like if you had any leadership experiences, that would be something that would fit this topic. Also, definitely just write a little bit about why you want to be a mod. Because we want to see someone who's like genuinely interested in helping the community or making a positive change, as opposed to someone that just wants to get in for the power of being able to ban people. If you want to ban hackers, fine, do that. But I would say, like, half the job is catching these rule breakers, and the other half is just interacting with the community, answering questions, and just talking to players and having a fun time. If you're not that kind of person, I wouldn't necessarily recommend applying, as just a lot of the time you're just talking to users, and they expect you to be like a public face for the community, and you need to be somewhat friendly. So that's essentially my guide for writing an application. I might be missing some things, and if you have anything of your own you obviously want to add, you think it'll help you get accepted, by all means, go ahead and do it. So, yeah. I would definitely recommend making your application slightly longer. Some people type up like 4 sentences, 5 sentences, or like small paragraph and think they'll get in. Like, while there is a point where like it's unnecessary to write more because you already fit everything they need to know in that body of text, writing too short of an application either shows you don't care or you won't be able to express all of you, like everything about you in that short bit of writing. So I know a lot of people that apply because I like give them suggestions on their applications, and lots of them write more than this 5,000 character limit and they still get denied. So it's pretty competitive. There's a large group of very experienced players applying every month with pretty decent applications. So don't think you can just write one sentence like, oh, I like Lifeboat, please give me mod, and you'll get in. Like, really watch the grammar and how you phrase your sentences. So, hope you all found that useful. Look forward to seeing some of you on the team soon if you do successfully manage to complete an application. Just keep in mind that reply-wise, you'll only get an email if you were accepted. If you were denied, you won't receive a reply. Only apply once a month. If you spam apply like every single day, you'll just get all your applications automatically rejected. It shows immaturity and impatience. So, yeah. Good luck to you all if you do decide to apply. And see you in the next video.